We're back up to nearly 10 miles an hour at the moment, which is very nice, very nice. The gradient's gone down, that's why. There we go. Right. That's it. Speed, there we go. There's the speed we're looking for. There's the speed. There's the speed. Hello everyone, I'm the Mole Man, and welcome to Clear Creek Narrow Gauge on Train Simulator. Yes. Welcome to Georgetown, Colorado. Today you'll be learning to drive the coal-fired B4D locomotive. Yes, I'm starting with the tutorial because I'm scared. The B4D locomotives were built by Baldwin in 1890 for the Denver, Leadville and Gunnison Railway, a Sunis narrow gauge predecessor. When the locomotives were built, they were the most powerful locos on the DLNG and were well suited to the mountain grades and tight curves of the Colorado narrow gauge. In 1902 and 1903, the class were heavily rebuilt by the CNS at Denver with new boilers. When air brakes were introduced, they had air tanks placed on top of the boiler between the domes and was standard on narrow gauge CNS locomotives. They were renumbered 63 through 70 by CNS and classified as the B4D. In the late 1910s, all CNS narrow gauge locomotives were given the distinctive Ridgway spark arrestor, which caught burning cinders leaving the chimney, while not affecting the flow of the exhaust. It was introduced to solve the problem of forest fires caused by steam locomotives. Yes, I can imagine so. I can imagine so indeed. The cinders could be emptied from the pipe down the side of the smoke box once they had cooled down. The Ridgway spark arrestor was often known to rail fans as the bear trap spark arrestor. Oh, there you go. There you go, that's the introduction to that. There we go. Right, let's see what we got, shall we? Oh, okay, right, even more. A table of B4DS specifications can be seen below. I'm not going to read all those out. You can read those. I'm sure you can. Pause if you desire. I must say thanks for Dovetail for sending this over. Milepost have done a cracking job on this route, and we're going to see it today, so there we go. The B4D has a built-in auto fireman with different settings depending on how much fire mass is required. Okie doke. Well, I've already got auto fireman turned on in the menu, so what's that going to... I don't know. This setting can be changed by pressing E to go up a level and Shift E to go down a level. Okie doke. Right. Let's see if I can remember that. I have no idea. No idea. Right. Okie doke. It's E and Shift E, and the dial's somewhere around here. Okay. Right, first you need to reverse out the depot to the water tank before you can get going up the grade, as you should be using the built-in auto fireman function, so you don't need to worry about firing. Okay, this could go horribly wrong. As you're using the built-in auto fireman, the F4 HUD does not fully work, so it's recommended that you use the F5 display, oh no, to keep an eye on the locomotive. Okay. To move, you must first release the train brake with the air reservoir pressure to get to 70 before trying to move. Once they've released, you'll be putting the reverse into full reverse and then applying the regulator to move somewhere just below full. Okay, once your speed hits 5 miles per hour, start decreasing the reverse and bringing it back towards neutral. This will increase your speed. As you're only going a small distance to the clear of the switch points in front of the water tank, you want to stop applying the throttle once you get to 10 miles an hour, and you should have enough momentum to roll back clear of the switch. Once the caboose crosses the switch, start applying very lightly applying the brake around to a 41%. When apply the brake more, so loco stops just clear of the switch. Okay, right, let's do that then. It says to get rid of that HUD and use this HUD. Oh boy. Right, so we've got to go into reverse. Right, we've got to go all the way down there. Okay, right, so that's it. So we take the brakes off. That's it. Where's the brake PSI on that thing? Oh, I need the other one, don't I? That's it, there we go. Brake cylinder pressure, that's it. I can just about see the numbers. I think they're fine. Right, we're into reverse. And we start going backwards. This is the tutorial. I'll play an actual scenario after this, so the video will be a bit longer. I just literally need to figure out what I'm doing here. I just need to figure it out indeed. But look at this beautiful little tiny steam locomotive. It's awesome. Absolutely tiny little thing. It's so cute and diddy, and I love it. Right, that's it. That's it. So we go back. That's it. There we go. Bring the reverser back, isn't it? That's it. Yeah. Speed up. There we go. And stop around 10 miles an hour when the caboose reaches somewhere. Over there, I think. I can't actually remember. Okay. We'll figure it out as we go. Right, that's it. And nearing 10 miles an hour. There we go. 10 miles. Oh, that'll do. That'll do. Right, and then start lightly applying the brakes. I think. That's it. Start applying the brakes. There we go. Start applying the brakes. There we go. Come off the brakes. That's not too bad. There we go. I slowed down way too much, so that's fun. way too much. Come on, train. Let's get going again. Oh, dear. Right, you know, I will get used to this, I promise. I'll get used to this. Right, here we go. Speeding back up. Right, brakes on a little bit. There we go. Brakes on a little bit. There we go. Where's the water bit? I've no idea where you put that. Oh, you put water in the tender, don't you? I'm assuming so. Stop way too early. Let's see. Let's have a look at the HUD. Oh, hang on. I've got to stop. Got to stop. Got to stop. Stop, 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 stop. That's it. That's good. Right. We're on self-lap. That's fine. Lovely. Look at that. There we go. Stopped in exactly the right place by the looks of things. Hopefully. We'll find out. Probably not. There we go. Now you must change the switch ahead. Oh, we're not actually taking on water then. Set the reverser to full forward and release the brakes. Once the brake pressure gets back to 70, you'll need the regulator. You need to the regulator. Okay, right. Once you get to about 5 miles per hour, start to bring down the regulator slowly. So it's down to about 45-50% by the time you reach 10 miles an hour. Right, got to change the switch in front of us. Let's go do that then. Drop that again. There we go. So we change the switch. Switch has been thrown, as they would say. There we go. Look, it's such a little diddy narrow gauge. I love it. Right, okie dokie. So we need to go full forwards. That's it. Full forwards. Sorted. Right. And brakes off. And full regulator, it said. That's it. Will slip, will slip, will slip, will slip, will slip. It said full regulator, damn it. Right, okie dokie. Or did it say full reverser? I've no idea. No idea. Oh, well, we're pulling away. It's fine. It's fine. That's it. Have I lost score for that? Yay, I lost score. Lovely. Right. That's it. Pull away. I'm hovering over a river right now, but that's fine. That's it. Pull away. Look at these little cute little diddy cars. Obviously, you'll notice it says Colorado and Central there. Because the Colorado and Southern is owned by, was originally part of BNSF, or when, you know, it was all the mergers made it part of BNSF. And because of the licensing problems, you can't have Colorado and Southern anywhere else in the world. So we have Colorado and Central, as I am in the UK. That's that for a fact. All right, let's bring the reverser down. That's it, reverser down. That should make us go a bit faster. No, it's not making us go faster. Come on, we need to go faster, damn it. We need to go faster. That's it, come on. 7.8 miles an hour at the moment. We can do this. I should have blown that across there, but there we go. Also got a nice bell as well. And it's animated. Look at that. It's animated. There we go. Right. Lovely. I'm not going very fast at the moment. I'm assuming it's quite the steep incline, actually. Probably. Probably indeed. Also realise I'm not actually doing all the I've got actual auto fireman turned on. It's doing it all by itself. Right. So now you're starting to hit the grade. It is important to keep an eye on your boiler pressure. As you are going to be climbing up a steep grade for some time, it is important you try and keep it between 135 and 150 PSI. It's 147 at the moment, so that's fine. Increasing the reverser at this point will increase your speed, but will use up boiler pressure. If you need to increase the reverser, you may want a small reduction in the regulator, so you use up less steam. I can't words. If you manage the reverser and regulator well, you should be able to keep the boiler pressure up. The bigger dial on the left-hand side of the cab displays boiler pressure. It can also be seen by using the F5 display. Right, so our boiler pressure is up here. So it's 147.7 at the moment. And we are currently using it a lot more than we are... oh dear, come on, come on, come on. Right, reduce the regulator, put that up. Come on, come on, you can do it. No, we're slowing down, we're slowing down. No, 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 no. I need to actually see the actual HUD for this. Right, come on, come on. More of that. Come on. Move, 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 move. No, don't start rolling backwards. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. Come on, come on. Come on, come on. Forwards, 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 forwards. What's my generation rate at the moment? Steam generation, steam, yeah, we're using a lot more than we're generating. That's a problem. That's a problem indeed. Come on, come on, come on. I wonder what happens if I tried using the auto fireman at this point. I have no idea. I don't even know where it is inside. Literally no idea. Go via stop warning. That's fun. Right, I want to go in here for a second. Where's the auto fireman thing in here? I saw it. I saw the dial for it on the... Oh, hello. I'm assuming it'd be round here somewhere. No? Okay. Is it round here somewhere? No idea. Right, okay, let's just sit over here. So these are the boiler pressure ones he was talking about. I need to keep it between... Yes, right. What is it at the moment? Okay, this isn't fun. No, it's fine, it's fine. Which my usage is a lot higher than my generation. So that's fun. So it's the number that should be around 145. Yes, it's 144 at the moment. Okay. Right, so what... Right, so let's bring... Let's increase the... Let's decrease the regulator. That's not going to work. We're slowing down. I've really knackered this. I think I've really, really knackered this. So this is going to go horribly wrong. We all know it to be true. We all know it to be true indeed. Oh dear, look at this. But it's, you cannot deny that this is pretty. A screenshot must be taken in this moment in time because that is just undeniably pretty. It really is one of those routes. It just has character to it. There we go. Oh yes, the screenshot noise has come back for some reason whatsoever. So there we go. There we go indeed. I haven't had that one in a while. It seems to have turned itself back on, so that's fun. Come on. Yeah, you can see the bear trap up there. And it runs down to the side once they've all cooled down. So that's cool. It's cool indeed. 3.4 miles an hour at the moment. Not ideal. Not ideal. That'll do. There we go. Just blow the whistle through there. 3.3 miles an hour. This isn't going well. This seriously isn't going well. My boiler pressure's doing good, so... Bring that down to speed up, right? Right? Yep, no. We're slowing down still. We're on a 3.4% gradient. I'll tell you what, the career scenario is going to go very well, isn't it? And this is going to take a lot longer. This is supposed to be a 10-minute introduction, apparently. I suppose that doesn't count reading everything, so that's fun. Come on. Come on. No, let's do it the other way. Come on. No, 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 no. Come on. Come on. Come on. You can do it. You can do it. You can do it. Come on. Don't go below 2 miles an hour. Set speed up. That's it. That's it. That's it. 2.6. 2.7. 2.8. 2.9. Oh, yeah. Here we go. Here we go. Up we go. Up we go. Lovely. Lovely. Slowly but surely. Slowly but surely. We're getting there. 3.5 miles an hour. It's the fastest we've ever gone. That's it. Come on. Up we go. Up we go. Look at this pretty little route. It's a pretty little route and it's amazing. It's so pretty. So pretty. Look at this. Little freight train. I love it. It's set in the 1930s, I think, this, isn't it? Or something like that. Very nice. And all this lot dates back to even before that. So it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool indeed. We're actually speeding up. And our usage... Our generation's higher than our usage. Yes. Look at that. There we go. Is the gradient leveled out? No. Nice. We're actually doing well then. Actually doing well indeed. Stop warning's approaching. Yeah, we're not exactly going very far, so it doesn't really matter. And stop point's up there. Bridge and end. So yeah, we're nearly there. We're nearly done. Nearly done. You'll be stopping at the stop point above the power station spur to practice starting on a grade. Okay. When you reach the stop point, turn the regulator off and apply the brakes around 80% before you start rolling back. Okay. Screenshot first. Okay. There we go. So just got to be prepared to stop, basically. So that's fun. See, look at that. This is a bad screenshot location, but look at that. That's awesome. There we go. Right. It said stop preparation. Where? I can't remember. Next, the power thing. We're stopping up there at stop point. Oh, okay. Yeah. See, I need to switch in the HUD so I can actually see where we're stopping. That's fun. Right. Look at this. We're actually speeding up. That's all good. That's all good. The generation usage has changed quite a lot. Okay, that's fine. That's fine for now. Absolutely fine. Shouldn't they be on running or self-laps or something? I don't know. Just leave them on release. That's it. Look at that. Absolutely beautiful, beautiful steam train. Look. You cannot deny. I always say this, but especially with steam trains, you cannot deny that that looks amazing. It's just a simple fact of life. That is one of the things that looks cool. There we go. Screenshot moment. There we go. There she goes. Colorado and Central. Fictional, but it'll do. There we go. Right. Going at a good speed. Going at a good speed. I need the HUD up now so I can see the stop point. That's the thing indeed. Don't worry about... Is this the power station? I might be. I don't know. That's it. Oh, it's up there. Okay, that's where we're stopping. Up there, I think. Or I've no idea. Round about here. Right, power off. That's it. Power off. You have now reached the location you'll be stopping, so it's time to turn off the regulator and apply the brakes. I shall be doing that. Right, that's it. apply the brakes. Well, no, I wasn't going to apply them that quickly, but okay. Well, we've stopped there. We should have probably moved forward a bit more, because we stopped very quickly. I wasn't going very fast. Right. Yeah, I should have stopped a bit further forward, but that's fine. That's fine. It'll do. It'll do. Look at that. It's an awesome little steam train. It's amazing. All right, to get going again, you must set the reverser forward as far as it can go. Release the brakes once the air reservoir pressure gets to around 60 psi. You also need to put the regulator on, putting the regulator on before it reaches 70 to prevent a rollback. To prevent wheel slip, you probably want to put the regulator again to 80% before turning up to 100. Once you get moving, it's also a good idea to turn the sander on when getting started. Right, sander. Sander's on. No, sander. Sander. There we go. Can I not keep the sander on? Oh, okay. Oh, it's on. There we go. It's on. Just there we go. I managed to get it on. Right, we're rolling back very slowly at the moment. Okay, that's fun. Right, so reverse it all the way forward. Off. Start applying. That's it. Start applying. Start applying. That's it. There we go. There we go. We're on our way. We are accelerating very slowly, but we're also keeping our pressure, so that's good. That's very good indeed. Right, there we go. Sorted. Look at that. It's awesome. Awesome indeed. Right, there we go. I can start on a gradient. This may have been a dodgy start to a scenario, but I'm doing well. And then we actually have to play a scenario, so that's going to be fun. That's going to be fun indeed. I've actually got to pay attention. So there we go. Just look at that. Lovely. Right. Away we go. Away we go. Ever so slowly. Ever so slowly. I love the little... I just love how small it is. It's awesome. It's the cute little dinky locomotive. Right, here we go. Speeding up nicely. Go via S bridge and S end. That's easy enough. Right. There we go. We're using up steam again. That's fun. There we go. Look at that. There's tracks everywhere. I love it. That's one thing I like about this route. The tracks just go absolutely everywhere. And you take about 6 miles of loops just to go about 2 miles in the real world. You know, sort of as the crow flies. And it's pretty cool in that regard. It's pretty cool indeed. Right, we need to do something about our usage rate somehow. What do you do? Bring the regulator down. No, that's not going to work. Bring that down. Is that going to work? No idea. Well, that slowed it down. Slowly. That slowed it down a little bit. That's fine. That's fine. There we go. Lovely. We're going to be stopping again at some point, I assume. That just seems about right. I'm going to take on some water myself. There we go. Look at this pretty little steam train. It's awesome. The sanders are still on. Let's change that. Let's see if we can manage without them. Well done. You have now got the train moving again. If you've not already done so, you will now want to reduce the reverser to keep up boiler pressure. Yeah, I'm reducing it, but I'm also not doing very well. No, I can't reduce it that much. That's it. No, that's it. That's the best I can do. The boiler pressure is still just dropping at this rate, and I'm slowing down, so that's not very good. Right. That's it. Now, the end's up here. Do I actually have to stop? That's the question. I doubt it. I think it'll just end. But before it does, one last screenshot, I reckon. I'm sure you'll all sympathise my screenshotage on this one, because it looks amazing. If I can get a good angle on it, that is. So look at that. That's just cool. There we go. There we go. Right. That's it. I need a total of 5 miles an hour. Generation usage has gone back up. See, that's showing the wrong numbers. So there we go. So now we can... Right, we completed the tutorial scenario. Yes, the train's just going to run off by itself now. So there we go. It's time to go and play an actual scenario, I think. We're going to be doing a passenger run, I believe. So let's go and do that, shall we? Let's go and do that, indeed. As the train just rolls past the screen there. Bye, train. See you in a minute. After that tutorial and history lesson, we are back in. Once you've loaded your passengers and collected your train order, you'll be ready to leave. Collected my train order. Okay. Right, let's do it then. Let's get the brakes into self-lapse. Let's get the doors open. There is a passenger vehicle and passenger coaches now, so we get to sit with these lovely people. So there we go. We get to face that way if we want to, or we can face that way if we want to look over the chair and sort of kneel and go, hello, or we can sit over here on this dude's lap, which is, there we go. So there we go. Right. Okie dokie. So there we go. Passenger, Colorado and Central. Beautiful little tiny coaches that look awesome. Let's get our headlight on. That's a start. Right, and let's also get prepared for the F5 HUD, maybe. That's it, there we go. Because that's what we're going to be needing, I think, today. It's what it seems to be recommending, isn't it? It's what it seems to be recommending indeed. Oh God, look at that. That's awesome. That's what I love about this. It's just absolutely amazing. Absolutely amazing. This is the over the loop scenario, so it's the shortest, I believe. Apart from the tutorials, it's the shortest scenario where we have to drive up the gradients, up the steep gradients of this route. So that's going to be fun indeed. It's going to be fun indeed. Right, come on. I do know there are buffers here, if you want to call those buffers. So that means we're probably going to have to reverse out of here, which is interesting indeed. Let's see how these passengers are getting on, shall we? There we go. Yeah, there's the doors. Those doors open. Hello, people. Right, there we go. On you get. Up the stairs and on you get. Right. All aboard. There we go. Right. Oh, hello. Look at that. Right, Form 19. Train Order 3. Date October 5th. There we go. Train 51 at Georgetown. Engine 64 on Train 51 from Georgetown to Silver Plume. There we go. Right, so that's what we've got to do. We've got our orders. We've now got to get out of here. And our first instruction is behind us somewhere? No. Over there. Right, we've got to reverse out of here. Okay. I can see why it taught us to do this in the first place. Right, there we go. So we're going to reverse out of here. Take the brakes off. That's it. Let's drop that so we can actually see what up here. Right, brakes are off. And away we go. Away we go. That's it. We're departing. There we go. Let's get the bell on as well as we depart. Locomotive number 64. There we go. I like that train order thing. The history of this. Getting the history in the train order. That's very sort of very characteristic. I like it. I like it indeed. That's it. Just use the bell as we get out of the station here. That's it. Look at that. The B4D. What's the speed limit around here? 18 miles an hour. Right. Lovely. I love this. I love how I just get to go out and just do it like this. This is awesome. There we go. That's pretty cool. Right, let's turn the bell off. You can probably also run around the locomotive, but I don't think there's any turntable around here. Or roundhouse, as it's also called. So there we go. I don't think there's anything round here for that. So we'd have to push everything or pull everything in reverse. I ain't doing that. Right, that's it. Let's sort of coast along now. And we're doing exactly the same thing as we were earlier. We're stopping here and then we're going along our way. Along the same way as we did last time as well. And the interesting thing about this, which makes it fun, is there's absolutely nothing to do with signalling on the entire route. Which I think is pretty cool. There we go. Right, it's come to a stop. That's it. Because our first waypoint is actually over there. So we need to stop here. That's it. Switch the points. Junction lock. Oh, is it? Yeah, it's changed themselves. Lovely, it's changed themselves. Right, forwards. That's it. There we go. We're now in forwards. Take off the brakes. When they reach around 70, we start applying the regulator. Lovely. Are we moving? I think we're moving. Slowly but surely, we are moving. There we go. Look at that. Off we go. Slowly, but now I've got to do so. Now the climb that we just did, I've got to do it again, but professionally, in a passenger service. So I need to actually build my speed up. So that's fun. Also, as well, I should have really turned the auto fireman off to use the actual one. But you know, we're not going to care about that because it said about using different ones for different gradients. So that's fun. That's fun indeed. Right, that's it. Come on, let's get going. Because we're on one of the shallowest gradients at the moment, at 1.4%. So let's just do this thing. That's it. The pressure's... Right, we're releasing the safety valves at the moment. So that must mean the pressure is actually all right. It must mean it's all right. There we go. Look at that. Off we go. On our way to our destination of the day, which is... Go via. We've got to go to Silver Plume, which is... See, it's 4.8 miles away, but this is a half an hour long scenario. Because we've got to do some interesting twists and turns to get there, I believe. I believe we have indeed. I do wish it... Does it show me the gradient on that? I don't think it does. I wish it would. Usage and generation are completely different right now, but that's because it's blowing off the safety valves. That's fine. We're speeding up nicely. Alright, we've just got to keep an eye out for the gradient. As soon as the gradient hits, everything's going to change. It's absolutely going to change. Look at this. Railroad crossing. Amazing stuff. I love the character of this. It's just, and also autumn as well. The trees are slightly browned off, just like it was in the last one I did as well. That was autumn. So there we go. But I like how it gives you the date, like October 5th. We're driving this on the October 5th, which is pretty cool. There we go. Right, the gradient has kicked in. We are slowing down. So I just got to remember how to do this. That's it. I've just got to remember how to do this. It's not like that. That's it. We do it like that, isn't it? Yes, we do it like that, I think. We're still slowing down. Come on. Speed up. Speed up. Speed up. Come on. Come on. Keep going faster. That's at 6.1. 6.2. That's fine. That's fine. There we go. We're on a 3.4 at the moment. It's going to get steeper. It's going to get steeper. It's going to go to 3.6 later on, so that's going to be fun. There we go. Up the hill we go. Up the hill we go. Come on. 6.8. 6.9. That's it. We're good. We're good. We're good. And we're still keeping our pressure, so that's absolutely fine. There we go. We're on our way. I'm going to take a screenshot to celebrate us being on our way. Look at that. See, that is just a characterful locomotive right there. That just looks amazing. Lovely. Right. That's it. Up we go. Up the. You can see the gradient. Look, you can see that. It's just ridiculous gradients there. Absolutely stupidly ridiculously steep gradients. I wouldn't want to go down it. Let's put it that way. 8 miles an hour. There we go. Speed limit is 18 miles an hour. I don't think somehow we're going to have to worry about that too much today, though. Not for some reason. I just don't see it being a concern. There we go. Right. Up the hill we go. Up the hill we go. Look at that locomotive is up the hill we go. There we go. Look at that. See, that just looks awesome. There we go. Lovely. Right. Up we go. 9 miles an hour. There we go. Right. See, it's going well. It's going well. I think, yeah, the speed limit is just a constant 18. And we've just got to go until we get there, I think. Yeah, pretty much. We might have to do some small switching when we get there. But as long as we pick up people at the platform, we're absolutely fine. It's putting water in. That's never good. That causes usage problems. Right, okay. Now look at our steam usage rate. That is not good. That is not good. It's quite high. I don't know how to fix that without slowing down. That's the problem. But it says, what does it keep your pressure between? 150 and 130. So as long as it stays around that, we'll be okay. If it gets any lower, we'll have to stop. So that's not fun. Oh, look, this track goes down there. That's a steep downhill gradient there. Look at that. That's quite the difference. That's quite the difference indeed. There we go. Look at that. Fire's roaring in there. So there we go. Very nice. Right, okay, let's drop the HUD again. There we go. 12.2 miles an hour. See, we're actually speeding quite nicely. And the usage rate is very high at the moment. And so is the generation rate. But we're going to have to bring off the speed at some point. Because we're actually going to start speeding. I'm doing a lot better than last time. That's for sure. But that might be just simply because we're hauling less behind us. There's only a few passenger coaches. That might be the reason. It might be. It might not be, but it might be. So, you know, we'll look on the bright side. Let's try and take a nice screenshot there. Just get rid of the HUD so I can see everything. There we go. Look at that. Just look at that. That's just awesome. Right, there we go. That looks amazing. Right, 13 miles an hour. So there we go. And I think we're slowing down again, actually. 13.7 miles an hour is where we're at the moment. We're slowing down. Right, why are we slowing down? Ah, the gradient has gone up. Okay. Right, so which one do I change to... I can't remember which one I change. That's the trouble doing the tutorial once and only once. I can't remember. Right, the regulator. I've put the regulator up a little bit. So we should hopefully start speeding back up again. In a perfect world. Which is this is by no means a perfect world. So that's fun. Putting water in again. Yeah, I'm using the in-game auto-fire, but not the one that comes with this. That's fun. Right. That's it. We're slowing down. We're still slowing down. Even more. Even more. Come on. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. No, come on. 12.2. You can do it. 12.1. No. 12 point. Come on. Stop slowing down. Every time I put the regulator up, it's slowing down. So that means I can't be the right thing to do. No, right. Okay. 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 Yeah, right. Yeah, you can see the boiler pressure is really suffering now. I might have to stop and let it build up again. Oh, it's gone green. It's gone green, but we're below 10 miles an hour. Ah. Right. What do we want to do here? I have no idea. Come on. Come on, train. Come on. You can do it. Just get up that hill. Get up the hill. Steam generation usage is more or less bang on at the moment. There we go. Come on. 9.1 miles an hour. We're going to be late going at this speed, but I'm not really too concerned about that at the moment. I'm more concerned about, well, just getting somewhere, I think, to be fair, to be quite fair. But look at that. That's just cool looking. That's just cool looking indeed. Take a screenshot there. I'll take another one as well, because, you know, we're feeling in the mood. There we go. Look at that. There we go. That's the money shot right there. Lovely. Right. 9 miles an hour. 8.9. We're slowing down. What's the gradient? Is it at 3.6% gradient? That's just not good. That's just not good. We're never going to be anywhere on time. That's just... Yeah, okay. It's the trouble. I like train sim when it works, but when you throw something that's difficult at me, I tend to not like it very much, because I like to be able to just drive trains. Right, let's try and take an interesting screenshot, shall we? Why not? Why not? Let's spice things up. There we go. Lovely. Right. Come on, come on, come on, come on. That's it. That's it. That's it. 8.7. Come on, just please, speed up, please. That one. Yeah, see, look, I put the regulator up. Not the reverser, I mean. And we're speeding up, but we're losing pressure. And our pressure's already quite low. So, that's not good. That's not good. We could ideally do with some more pressure. Come on, pressure. Can I have you, please? It's like I can't have pressure and speed. It's so annoying. So annoying. Come on. Come on, train. You can do it. You can do it. You can do it. No, we're slowing down. The gradient's gone up to 3.8. What the hell? Right. Okay. Come on. Come on. You can do it. You can do it. No. You can do it. Oh, look at the pressure. It's so low. It's not good. I might have to stop at this rate and just let the pressure build back up again. 7.8. 7.7. This isn't good. I'm going less than half the speed limit. I ain't going to worry about speeding today, that's for sure. All right. Come on. Oh, why are you putting water in now, game? This isn't going well. I've got a terrible feeling I might have to start this again, but I don't want to have to start this again, because it'd be horrible. But just know this is going to go horribly wrong. That's all I'm going to say. That's all I'm going to say. We're going to be terribly late. We're never going to make it. It's going to go horribly wrong, and it's all going to just fall apart and go blah. That's what it's going to do, but there we go. Let's just take a nice screenshot. Let's just enjoy the view, shall we? There we go. Just enjoy the fact that that looks amazing, if not anything else. There we go. But yes, we're going on an incredible 7.2 miles an hour. The pressure is just abysmal right now. Come on. I need the gradient to level out a little bit, please. You see that bridge? Yeah. Keep an eye out for that bridge, because we'll probably be crossing it later. You'll find that the track does weird and wonderful things. You really will. We'll probably... I don't know if we actually go across it today, but I know that this is one big loop. Like, there, you literally go up here, you go around another bridge over there, you come back, and then you go around, I think. I think that's how it works. At least in some form or another, that's how it works. Come on, we're actually speeding back up again. And the pressure's building back up. Oh, yes, come on, we can do it. We can do it, come on. 7.2 miles an hour, look at that. There we go, going under a bridge. Very nice, very nice, very nice. Come on, come on, up we go, up we go, up we go. 7.3, yes, lovely, right, tookie dokie. We're speeding up and we're gaining pressure, so we're doing good. Ah, we're doing very good indeed. Oh dear, 7.4, yes. And the gradient looks like it levels out a little bit here. Might have a chance to actually build some speed up and pressure. We're back up to 140. There we go, right. Look at that, there we go. I just love the little dinky wheels in this thing. It just looks so cute and tiny. I love it. Milepost Simulations, you did an epic job on this one. For those of you who don't know, Milepost also made Canadian Mountain Passes and the West Highland Line South Routes. There you go. There you go, indeed. They do know what they're doing, and they proved it. They definitely proved it with this one. With this little characteristic route. I say little, it's probably pretty big. I don't know. I haven't driven across the whole thing yet. There's no way I'm going to end up driving across the whole thing at this rate. Literally take weeks. There we go. There we go, speeding up, that's it. Alright, so now we can drop down the regulator, or no, the reverser I mean, because we'll speed up by ourselves, because the gradient's gone down. That's it, there we go. Just let the train speed up, there we go. 2.1% gradient right now, the shallow part of the route. There we go indeed. Makes you wonder how much you end up climbing in this time. It must be quite a lot. You must climb a lot in this short distance. It must be crazy. Absolutely crazy. Let's take another screenshot there. There we go. Look, see, just look at that. Little 64. There we go. I forgot my words. There we go. That's just cool looking right there. That's cool looking indeed. There we go. Lovely. Right. There we go. Generation usage has fallen apart again, according to the HUD. That HUD. Yeah, okay. Yeah, water's going in again. Lovely. Lovely. I'm more using this HUD for the gradient rather than anything else. I am indeed. Why is there a 5 limit up there? That's not fun. Okay, yeah, so look, we're crossing round onto the other side of this. And I think we're climbing up to that bridge that we've just on. So that's fun. At 15 miles an hour, let's do this thing. That's it. Pressure's still building up slightly. We're still going at quite the pace, which is quite nice. There we go, look at that. It's the fastest we've ever gone, 16 miles an hour. Oh, blimey, O'Reilly. Look at this. Up we go, up we go. Right, we have got to be, there is a 5 up here. We've got to be careful of that. We have got to be careful of that indeed. Right. And look at this. See, there's that bridge. I think we're going to cross that bridge that we just went under. That's what I like about this. You go around all the loops. It's fun. It's definitely fun. What's our next waypoint? It's still over there, isn't it? Yeah, we've still got to go all the way over there. That's fun. Right. We're going to start speeding in a minute. So let's slow down. Because we have got to slow down to 5, I think, for the bridge. The bridge that has got a speed limit of 5 miles an hour. Right, that's it. That's it. Just let the truck, because this will give the chance for the boiler pressure to build itself back up again, so that's good. That's good indeed. I shouldn't even need to use the brakes. The gradient should slow us down. That's it. 8, 7, 6. Bit of, that's it. There we go. 5. Lovely, lovely. Right, now just got to keep that 5. Now just got to keep that 5. That's it, keep that 5. Right, as we cross the bridge, which we just went under. Literally just went under. Right. We're going to take a screenshot as we roll past the... there we go. That's a screenshot location right there. If we ever saw one, I reckon that's a screenshot location. That's it. Don't speed. That's it. 5.6. That's good. Yes, this bridge... We'll have a look at the bridge in a second. Because from this perspective, it doesn't look like it could hold a locomotive. It really doesn't look like it has the grunt to do it. There we go. Let's just take a screenshot around about that sort of location, I think. Something like that, maybe. I reckon that looks the part. There we go. Right. You'll see what I mean. Look. It just looks so spindly from up here. Looks like this should not be able to hold a train. But it does. There we go. And it's still going uphill. That's fun. I wonder what screenshots we could take from the bridge perspective. Let's have a look, shall we? There we go. Once you've stopped in the depot, you must pick up a new train for order... I think it's talking to me as if I've already got there. Which I definitely haven't got there. So that's fun. That's not fun. Why is it telling me that already? I have no idea. No idea. It's telling me about the depot, but I'm nowhere near the depot yet. I think the game thinks that is way too confident in my ability to drive this thing. That's what we're seeing here. Careful of the speed there. That's it. Look at that. Gunning it along the track. Very awesome indeed. Lovely. Right. There we go. 5 miles an hour is still ours. Off the bridge. There we go. Lovely. Let's see what it's like from in here, shall we? Oh, that's fun. We go in here. Turn around. Hey, dude. Oh, my God. Okay. Look at that. Just slowly crossing is awesome. That's it. Bit more power again. I was kind of hoping the boiler pressure would recover in that. Well, it has recovered, sort of. Back up to 147, which is good. That's it. All right. And the gradient's probably going to kick up again soon. That's fun. That's fun indeed. Yeah, we're going a lot slower, I think, than the game wants us to be anywhere. Yeah. Okay. So it wants us to be there at 11:53. That might happen. I doubt it. 11:55. Okay. Yeah. Well, that one's going to be 11:51, but that's going to be 11:55. Right. Come on, train. Speed back up now. You can do it. Back up to thingy, please. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. I need you to get back up to 18 miles an hour. It's not going to happen, is it? Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. You can do it. You can do it. Why is it when the speed limit goes up, the gradient also goes up? Why not give me a chance to speed up before you increase the gradient? That's just not fair. Come on, route builders. 1930s route builders. Come on. Why not do this? Come on. That's it. We're speeding up. I think we're speeding up. Yeah, we're speeding up. We're speeding up. Slowly but surely, we're speeding up. We're going to be ever so late. It's going to be hilarious. Right. There we go. Lovely. That's it. Generation usage is seeming good. It's seeming good. So that's good. Right. And the speed is going up slowly but surely. So that's always a fun thing indeed. There we go. Well, just look at that. But the sun's lighting up one side over there. We're all shrouded in the darkness as we can't drive. Look at that. That's what you're here for, isn't it? The beautiful views like that. There we go. Right. Screenshot. Lovely. And up the gradient we go to 3% gradient as it is. Yeah, 3%. Lovely. 6 miles an hour. Oh, joy. Right, come on. We can do it. Let's stick our heads in here, shall we? Haven't been in here for a while. Looks very nice in here. I do like it. I do like it. So there we go. It is very nice. All our coal is there. So there we go. There we go. There's not much room behind us. Literally nothing. It's so small. That's the thing with narrow gauge. You just no room anywhere. So there we go. There is our reverser right there. So there we go. Our regulator is probably this. That's our driver injector. That's our sander. That's probably one of our brakes. Yep. That's probably one of our brakes as well. Yep. Where on earth is the thingy in here? Is that the whistle? That's the whistle indeed. Where on earth is the regulator in this part? I've no idea. Absolutely no idea. But we're speeding up nicely, so that's good. 7.3 miles an hour. Look at that. There we go. There we go indeed. Can we stick our heads out? Can we stick our heads out at all using that camera? No, but can we stick our heads out doing that? There we go. Lovely. We're on our way up to Silver Plume Depot today. There we go. Right. We can do this. 7.2 miles an hour. We've got just under 2 hours to go. Yeah, this is no LGV route, that's for sure. Definitely no sort of LGV route right here. Look at the sun lighting up the trees down there. It's all yellow, bright and awesome. There we go. As we're clung to the side of this cliff face right here. Come on, you can do it, you can do it, you can do it. Now don't slow down. Oh, the gradient's gone up. Why is the gradient gone up? Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on, you can do it, you can do it, you can do it, you can do it. That's it. That's it. Speeding back up again. There we go. That's it. Look at that. Making it slowly but surely. We can do this, we can do this. Right, we can do this. We have the power. There's the bridge, and there's the track down there. You can see the track down there, actually. It's pretty cool if we just look over here. You can see the track down there, the big loop. That's what we just did. We just did a massive loop like that. So that's pretty cool. So we're now, literally, for the last few seconds, we've been actually gaining in terms of just geographical locations. That's cool. Right, that's it. We're going to go past this place, and it's going to look awesome. Just the given fact of life, really. This is going to look awesome. There we go. Look at that. There's the little steam train of awesome. There we go. Take a nice screenshot of the trees of the words. There we go. Right, lovely. Fantastic. So power up there. Some of the freight wagons are like little cabooses. They're fun. They're fun indeed. They got passenger views as well, which is quite cute. So there we go. We're back up to nearly 10 miles an hour at the moment, which is very nice. Very nice. The gradient's gone down. That's why. There we go. Right. That's it. Speed, there we go. There's the speed we're looking for. There's the speed. There's the speed. Lovely stuff. And the gradient's gone back up again. So we're probably going to start slowing down, aren't we? Probably. Yep. Slowing that down. No, don't do that. Don't put regulator up and have me slow down. That's not fair. Come on. 9 miles an hour. We're going at half the speed limit. Half the speed limit. We're going to be so late at this rate. We've barely gone half a mile since when I last checked. That's fun. That's fun indeed. Well, I suppose that's the character of this route, isn't it? That's where the fun comes from. It's mastering the controls of this locomotive. That's where you get your kicks out of this one, I feel. So if you like trying to master difficult trains, you're definitely going to enjoy this. Let's put it that way. So there we go. And obviously as well, narrow gauge. This is the narrowest gauge, I believe, available at the moment. It's about 3 foot, I think. I don't know what actual gauge it is. It's about 3 foot, maybe, possibly. I don't know. But it is one of the, it is like really narrow gauge. Because Story Forest Rail and the South African route, they're Cape gauge. What's that, 3 foot 6 inches? I think this is 3 foot. So it's just interesting like that, actually. Very interesting indeed. So it's nice to see more narrow gauge stuff coming. So that's nice. Always nice to get some bit of narrow gauge. So if you like narrow gauge, obviously, this is for you. So there we go. There we go, indeed. There's also a bit of dual gauge on this route, but I don't think it works with standard stuff. I don't think it does. It offsets everything, so that's a bit odd, but there we go. But there is a couple of standard gauge stuff included with this, but it's literally just for static purposes. Just, I suppose, just to show you the difference, really. Why are we slowing down? Because the gradient's gone up again. Of course it has. Come on. You can do it. You can do it. You can do it. God, look at this. This looks awesome. There we go. As we're going into some sort of cutting here. It's like a cutting screenshot banter for the win. There we go. Look at that. That's nice. That's nice. That's just nice. Right. There we go. Going through here. It's very narrow through here. Okay. Yeah, very, very, very narrow through here. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. This is, yeah, okay. Quite narrow. Quite narrow indeed. Right. That's it. Ooh. Wouldn't want to stick your head out there. Keep your hands in the way. Keep, stick just everything inside. Don't stick your head out or anything. You'll lose your face. There we go. Right. Over another bridge. Across here. There we go. We just literally crossed it over there. I've no idea where we're going now. Right, here we go. Come on, speed. Come on. Going at 8 miles an hour. This is ridiculous. This is ridiculous. It's probably videos already of people driving this thing going, oh, look, I can go a million miles an hour whilst doing this. It's like, that's nice for you. I can't drive these things. Right, here we go. Look at that. That just looks cool. There we go. That just looks cool. Try and get a nice screenshot of that looking cool. I think that does indeed look very cool. There we go. There's just so much scenery to this. I mean, look, there's trees and, you know, going all the way up there. All those rocks and stuff. It just looks amazing. There we go. Come on. No, we're slowing way down again. Come on. Come on. Oh, the pressure's dropped so far. It's at 133. That's not good. That is anything but good. Oh, dear. Oh dear, this could go horribly wrong in the next few seconds. We could have to stop and let the pressure build back up or something horrible like that. That might end up occurring, and if it does end up occurring, this could be very awkward indeed. There we go. Lovely. Come on, train, you can do it, you can do it, you can do it. Come on, you can do it. I believe in you, train! I believe in you! Just, that's it, power up. Power up. Get those wheels a-turning. Get those wheels a-turning. That's it. Use your coal to your advantage. There's also an oil-fired one included with this. This is coal. You can also get an oil one, but I haven't driven this. I haven't driven that. I'm not going to drive that yet. I'm too scared at the moment to even consider driving a different kind of train. That's it. That's it. There we go. Lovely. Look at that. No, come on. That's it. Pressure build back up, please, quickly. We're also on the shallower gradient. That'd be great. Also, I'd like the speed to build up as well. If we could be so kind, that'd be nice. There we go. Look at this, we've literally stuck in this same little section for ages. We've done all of that, and now we're going up here and going all the way up there, and then we're continuing on. Bloody hell, I love it. It's amazing. Right, what sort of screenshot we can get around here? Look how sharp this is. Amazingly sharp. There we go. We're speeding up as well, which is pretty good. I'm not gonna lie. There we go. Coming round the bend. There we go. Look at that. That just looks cool. There we go. 10 miles an hour as well. We're slowing down. Gradient's gone back up again, isn't it? Probably. Of course the gradient would have gone up. Why wouldn't it have gone up? Yep, gradient's gone back up to 3.6. Lovely. And the pressure in that time did absolutely nothing. That's fun. Come on, pressure. Come on. Come on, speed. Come on. This is not going to go well for us. We're slowing down. We ain't got the pressure to climb this anymore. That's just it. I think the train's about to give up. We're a mile away. That's taken a whole mile of loops right there. At least a mile of loops. Oh my god, train. Come on. You can do it. You can do it. You can do it. You can do it. Come on. No. It's not happening. It's not happening. Well, we're supposed to have been there by now. So, something tells me this is going horribly wrong. Like, disastrously horribly wrong. So that's fun. Yeah, the pressure's pretty low right now. And we're slowing down. Right. Literally nothing else I can do right now, I don't think. Come on. Come on. Come on. Please, just accelerate. That's it. Accelerate. That's it. That's it. And the pressure, let's just ignore the pressure, shall we? It's going up. It's going up. Yes, it's going up, and so's the speed. Whilst the gradient is nearly 4%. That's it. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. You can do it. This is just like, yeah, encouragement. Episode encouragement. There we go. That's it. That's all we're talking about today. You can do it. You can do it. There we go. That's it. That's it. 6.3 miles an hour. 6.4. How are you supposed to do this going at like 18 miles an hour? I have no idea. So there we go. There we go indeed. But we're less than a mile away from our first waypoint. I've only spent ages doing it. We've still got another... Oh my, okay. We've got that far to go. So that's fun. So we've got Silver Plume Depot track. And it showed me that information way too early. So now I have absolutely no idea what... I can't even remember what it said. So that's fun. That's fun indeed. Oh, the pressure. Oh, the pressure. It's got to the lowest point it should be. I reckon I'm going to have to stop and let it build back up now. That's fun. Come on. Please. Please. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Why are you putting water in now? That's not fun. That makes the pressure go down even faster. No, we're right. Okay, we're going to have to let the pressure build up. Pressure build up time. That's it. That's it. There we go. Right. Let's just sit around, shall we, and see if we can't get this pressure to build up. I think that's what we need to do indeed. Pressure build-up time, I suppose. Yeah, that's it. There we go. It's building up. It's building up. So, I shall see you once it's built up, I suppose. This is taking forever, for one. It's just reached 130, and the locomotive is slowly rolling backwards. So, this is a bad situation I've got myself into here. Very bad indeed. I might not be able to continue this. So we shall see. We shall see. We shall see. Come on, pressure. Build back up, please. 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 I do that. And that work? That. No. Okay. Come on, pressure. Do your thing, please. Please. Build up very, very slowly. Very, very slowly. But a bit faster than very slowly, please. Okay. Okay. You know what I'm going to say? I'm going to say screw it. That's it. Screw it. Screw it. Go. 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 Just go. Just do it. Just do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. There we go. That's it. Just go. I don't care anymore. I'm already late. I'm very, very late. That's not good. The score's going to be atrocious. This could be one of the worst scores I ever get. If I ever get there. So yeah, I don't even care about the pressure right now. I don't care anymore. I've sat there for ages and it barely built up anything, so that's fun. Right. That's it, come on. Come on. Come on. That's it. That's it. Pressure's going back down. Yeah, don't care. Right. That's it. That's it. There we go. At least I got started on a gradient nail down. At least I know I'm doing that. So that's good. That's good. That's good. 6 miles an hour. Alright. I just want to get this 0.74 miles out of the way. But other than that, I'm going to have to deem this a complete and utter failure until I've learned to drive it a bit better. Because there's no way I can continue doing all of this. Because that's another lot of distance and it's all uphill, I think. That's fun. That's fun indeed. That is very fun indeed. 7.2 miles an hour, 7.1, 7.2, 7.1, 2, 1, 2, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1, yeah, to me, to you, to me, right, okie dokie, right, that's it, come on train, you can do it, you can't do it, can you? I've knackered you, you cannot do this whatsoever, because I've completely and utter knackered you. That's what we're learning today, I completely and utter knackered a locomotive, I think, so that's fun indeed. Yeah, I've knackered this. I think I'm pretty sure I've knackered this because I'm going at 7 miles an hour when I should be going a lot faster. So yeah, I think we can successfully deem this one a failure for now. I definitely think that's a thing. So we'll definitely call it a failure. But whether I'm contemplating whether to just give up at the next waypoint, considering I just haven't gone anywhere. The give up contemplation is definitely setting in as a possibility because it's not looking good for me. Going at a massive 7 miles an hour. Oh, look at the pressure. 127. That's not good. If it goes too low, we'll literally just start rolling down the hill and then we'll just be knackered. Absolutely knackered. There we go. Gives us a chance to appreciate the locomotive in slow motion now, I suppose, doesn't it? Yeah, we're going up the hill in slow motion. That's what we're doing. No, we're not. No, we're not going up in slow motion, I'm afraid. I'm just a terrible, terrible driver. So there we go. There we go, indeed. Let's just enjoy the look of the train, shall we? Oh, why did I decide this was a good idea? I have no idea why I decided this was going to be a good idea. There we go. Look at that, an impressive 70 miles an hour. 70? Oh, I wish. 7 miles an hour, I should say. That's it. Where's our waypoint? It's all the way up here, isn't it? Where is it? Let's have a look. It's, yeah, it's up here. There's another train waiting. I bet you're precious lovely. You'll get to go down. You're going to have fun doing that. I've literally just got to get to the depot. Right, so I've got to get here. I literally got to pick up passengers. I haven't even made it yet, so that's fun. I'd have to go all the way over there. I might make it. I might make it. You never know. That's our final destination for the day. So I might make it, just very, very late. Hopefully, the passenger stop here at Silverplume will give us a chance to, you know, build up our speed. Who knows? Maybe I won't give up. Maybe there's still a chance. Who knows? Who knows? What's it look like on here? Oh, yeah, the usage is 10,000 and the... Yeah, okay. Come on, I like how it's just holding 7 miles an hour, though. I like that. It's like reached a point in the game now where it's just sort of like, you cannot drive me, so I'm giving up and giving you a default speed. Look at that cliff! Oh, my God. Right, okay. Yeah, let's not look that way. Let's just look at the wall. That's better. Hello, lady. Don't look that way. There's a cliff. Right, there we go. That's it. Come on, we can make it up the hill indeed. The score on this is going to be absolutely atrocious. I just know that to be a fact. And this video is going to be unnecessarily long where I cannot drive a steam train up a hill. That's just going to be a thing. I could drive a steam train London to Brighton, don't get me wrong. That's a completely flat route. There we go. But not here. Definitely not here. This is one that's going to require a lot more practice in the future before I even get remotely competent at it. So there we go. That's fun. That's fun indeed. There we go. Just look at this. Look what else coming in there. I'm surprised I can blow the whistle at the moment. There we go. Lovely stuff. Like, how does the train even have the pressure to blow the whistle right now? That's the question. That's the question indeed. Right. There we go. Dropping all the ashes. Can we actually see them or not? I don't think we can see them. I don't think so. No, I don't think so. There we go. Little dinky locomotive. Right, come on. Come on. We can do it. Just go. Go. Make it to the last little bit. There's Silverplume Depot South Track. We're picking up our first lot of passengers. Hang on. Sorry we're late. There we go. We're coming. Don't you worry. We had a bit of a hill problem. It's my first day. You can imagine the struggle. Right, there we go. There we go indeed. Yeah, I bet this driver's going to give me a look as we go past, isn't he? I think he will. But look at the gradient. There we go. Not that it really matters because the pressure's so low. We cannot build up speed whatsoever now. We might be able to. Oh, there we go. Yeah, that'd help. If I drop the regulator down, might build up some speed. There we go. I'll probably be going a lot faster this entire time. That's what proves how stupid I am. No, look. We literally can't go any faster than 10 miles an hour right now. Even if I try, that's just not good. Anyway, it's the gradient's leveled off. That's why we're speeding up. Shh. Don't you give me your look. I know. All right. That's it. This gives a chance for the pressure to build up a little bit whilst we're here. There we go. That's it. Sorry we're late, folks. Had a bit of hill problems, as you might well imagine. But rest assured, I'm not going to quit. We'll get you there. We'll get you there indeed. That's it. Apply the brakes. Boom. Come to a stop. And, yeah, we're a bit late. Like, we're like 11 minutes late or thereabouts. So the score is going to be questionable, to say the very least. Questionable, to say the very least, indeed. There we go. Come on, pressure. I need you to build back up. Like, a lot more than you're currently building up. There's nothing I can do about that, is there? Literally nothing. No. Okay. Because the auto fireman's doing it, I can't control anything, so that's fun. That's fun indeed. Alright. I'm sorry about being late. Score. Oh, okay. Train order. Engine 64 and train 41 from Silver Plume to Pavilion and turn on Y. Time 11:50. Yeah, a bit late. Minus 12,580. Yes. Right. Okay. Okay. Right. Okay. This is going horribly wrong, isn't it? This is going horribly, horribly wrong. That's just everything this is right now. Just look at the pressure. It's woeful, the pressure. There we go. I just cannot drive steam trains. But there we go. There we go indeed. Not uphill anyway. Downhill's quite easy. Just manage the brakes. Right, go via Silver Plume Y main track, which is that. Have I got to stop there? I think I'm... Go via, and then pick up passengers there. Let's have a look, shall we? Right. So we've got to go via that bit. Go via... Oh, okay. So we've got to go via this bit up to there. Whoa! Well, camera! 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 There we go. Right, so it just started buggering off by itself. So we've got to go there, then there. So we've got to go... We've actually got to reverse in. Okay. Okay. Right, are the points the right way? They are the right way indeed. Train speeding up nicely now that we're on this relatively straight. There we go. And narrow as well. There you go. The straight and narrow gauge. There we go. Ba-dum. That's me. That's my comedy for the day. There you go. I'm here all week. Right, okie dokie. Speeding up. Not speeding up at all, actually. Like, literally not at all. Just, it's because of the pressure. I've just knackered this completely. I shouldn't be allowed to drive steam trains up a hill because I have no idea what I'm doing. Even after playing the tutorial, I have literally no idea what I'm doing. So that's fun. That's fun indeed. Alright, so we've got to stop at Silver Plume Y main track. There we go. Oh dear. Hello, little... Hello, houses. How are you doing? I just love how small this loco is compared to all the houses. It's so cool. Why was... Oh no. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on. Come on. That's it. That's it. That's it. Come on. Just make it up the hill, please. I know I've done horribly. I know I've done horribly, but you can't blame me now. There we go. There we go. Come on. Oh dear. Right, okie dokie, come on, we can do this, we can do this, we can do this. We can get up the hill. Just get up the hill. I know the gradient's gone up, but you know, and because of gravity and stuff, we should be able to roll to our final destination. We shouldn't even need anything else. The score's going to be atrocious by the time I get there, isn't it? Oh, it's going to be bad. It's going to be bad. I'm not even worthy of a wooden spoon by the end of this. I won't even win that. So, I'll literally... My win will be to clean up this locomotive after I ruined it. That'll be my win. There we go. Alright, come on, speed. Total of 6 miles an hour. There we go. There we go, indeed. Oh, my, oh, my, oh, my. I shan't be driving this again for a little while. Not till I've learnt it, anyway. Not till I've learnt it. So, that's fun. That's fun, indeed. We're nearly at Y main track. Yeah, why? Why? There we go. Right, okie dokie. Let's just stick up over here. There we go. Look at this. So we're gonna go past this bit, which is fun. Go up here, and then go back that way. Because that's a station, apparently. This is a station. And I'm very late. Yeah, I was supposed to be here at 11:53. I'm going to be here at 12:07. Okay. Okay. In fact, I should have finished the scenario by now, so that's awkward. There we go. That just shows how well I'm doing. It's going to be a long video, isn't it? It's not supposed to be, but it's going to be. Timeless penalty, minus 20. Oh, minus 32,660. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. That's what we're talking about. I think the pressure's got to a point now where it's just unrecoverable, I think. I've knackered this train completely. The gradient's gone up. This isn't good. I need to get up the hill. Come on. Just need to get past the switches there. Come on. Come on. Come on. That's it. Just force it up the hill. Force it up the hill. Can you all get out and push? Hang on, hang on, hang on. Can you all get out and push, please? Thank you. Right. And then just let go. Just let it go. And we'll just roll back down here into the station. Oh, this isn't good. Come on, I just need to get past this point here. Literally, this point, or switch, as it's known in America. Point's over here. There we go. Just get past here, and then I can stop. And then I can just relax and just reverse in and see how badly that I did. How badly I did indeed. So that's fun. That's fun. That's it. 6 miles an hour. There we go. Look at the little dinky wheels that are holding up the entire carriage. That's so cool. There we go. That's it. That's it. Come on. Come on. Nearly. 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 Right. Power off. Alright, power back on a little bit. That's it. Wait for the points to switch by themselves, hopefully. Are you going to switch or am I going to switch ya? I'm going to switch ya. Right, off. There we go. Right. You should just start reversing by yourself now, shouldn't you? Just put you into reverse gear. There we go. I don't have to do anything now. The train's going to drive itself. So there we go. There you go. Look, this is going to be the fastest we've ever gone because I'm not driving it. Gravity's doing this bit. There we go. What a weird way to enter a station, though. Seriously, what a weird way. That's it. Right, I need to be careful of the everything here, because we are now literally... Timeless penalty! Look at that. Right. We are now literally going to be going too fast for anything. Because we have got to stop here. So that's fun. Right, that's it, that's it, that's it. Is that the platform? That is indeed the platform. Right, there we go. Hello, passenger. Well, there's no one here. They probably gave up and all went home, and I do not blame them. I do not blame them. There's one person. One person decided to stick it out for me, and I thank them. That's it. Alright, stop. Stop. Oh, boy. Right, okie dokie. We arrived. We're a bit late, but we arrived. Oh, it's a dude. Okay. There we go. Lovely. Right, here we go. Well, we made it. Horribly late, and this is probably one of the worst scores I've ever gotten in a scenario. So there we go. That's one for the record books right there. One for the record books indeed. The final score is going to be one hell of a lot worse. I can tell you that for free. I can tell you that for free indeed. So there we go. There we go. Let's take a look at that train right there. Let's drop the HUD. There we go. What's the final score going to be? It's going to be a sucker, isn't it? Oh, God. Okay. Oh, another minus 20,000. Okay. Minus 75,134. Steam trains and hills? Not for me. You'll be waiting here until the afternoon. Train back to Denver. Scenario complete. Right, yeah. I'm not going to do that again for a little while. I'm going to do a bit of practice first. I think you'll all agree. I think you should all quite happily agree that I should never be allowed to drive these things again in my life. So I'm just going to go and hang my head in shame. And that's going to be that. That's going to be that indeed. So thank you very much for watching this one. If you enjoyed it, then please like, comment and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video where hopefully we'll have a little bit more luck. A little bit more luck than this time. So yes, yeah, see you next time, folks. Until then. What train we got approaching now? Another Southern? Oh, looks things. Yeah, another Southern. Southern banter. That's fast. That's very fast indeed. There we go. Look at that. That's just an awesome view right there. That's just an awesome view indeed. There we go. We're going all the way to Brighton.